Hello, Taurus. Welcome to your weekly forecast. Thank you so much for joining me today. Hope you guys are all doing well and enjoying your weekend. The weekend is off to a good start. This is your weekly forecast for the week ahead, Saturday through Saturday. So it will be, you know, I haven't put any dates in there, but I haven't really felt like putting numbers and dates on things lately. So it is what it is. But anyway, you can watch this reading if you are a Taurus sun, moon, or rising, a Taurus on the house cusp. If you have your sun in the second house or Venus in Taurus, you can watch this reading also. I should note, I did add, if you have your north node or your rising sign in Taurus, definitely watch this reading, or your north node in the second house. Okay. Definitely watch this reading. So all the decks we're using are listed down below, as well as my contact information. Personal reading information is down there. Want to book a personal private tarot reading with me? You can definitely do that. Check out my website and scheduling page. The easiest way to book is through my scheduling page, which you can find up in the right-hand corner. Just click the eye in the sky. That will take you to my scheduling page where you can book a reading at your convenience. We're going to start off with the earth portion of the reading. This is the earth, wind, fire tarot spread. And if you have any questions about why I changed up my forecasting spread, you can refer back to last week's weekly forecast that I did for Taurus, where I explained my sort of change in plans here going forward. So let's go ahead and jump into it. And we're going to start with your work and career. What is coming in for Taurus this week in terms of their work and career spirit? What do they need to know? Show me work and career for Taurus. What is coming in for Taurus? We have the Three of Cups, Nine of Pentacles. You could be collabing with a Virgo. All right. I do see also a celebration here. So I don't know, maybe work and pleasure, business and pleasure are being combined here in some fashion. However, I do see Virgo's energy. I also see Mercury in Cancer. You could be doing something with social media. I heard friends building or friend building. So you could be definitely working on your friendships right now, working on your connections, working on your community, doing something with community building. Clarify the Three of Cups and the Nine of Pentacles for Taurus's week ahead in terms of their work and career. The High Priestess and the Universe. Ultimately, this works out in your favor. Something is getting wrapped up this week. You may be consulting a practitioner, or you are a practitioner. That's for someone out there, not everyone. Not everyone is a tarot reader. Come on now. if everyone's a tarot reader, that would explain a lot of things, I guess. But before I get into that, Three of Pentacles, Nine of Pentacles, the High Priestess, the Universe. You're making silent moves to close out a chapter here. So this looks good. I also feel like in terms of your own stability, your own success, you're definitely, you can do battle by yourself here. Or this is the Virgo that you're dealing with. All right, I'm going to put these back, and you could be closing on a major project this week, wrapping things up. This is a big, big accomplishment for you, though. Okay, whatever this is for your working career, it's a big accomplishment. Show me money and finances for Taurus this week. What is coming in for Taurus in terms of their money and finances? Show me Taurus. This card is peeking out. The Princess of Cups. A water sign. You could be receiving a message from a water sign. What does this have to do about what does this have to do with Taurus's money and finances? I'm asking spirit, what does this have to do with Taurus's money and finances? King of Pentacles. That's you. Well, things look good in money, in the money and finances arena. Who's the Princess of Cups? A Libra? You could also be doing something with the legal document, a marriage contract, some paperwork here. There's some legal paperwork here that you have to sign. This could also be like splitting accounts up or joining accounts. However, your money and finances look great this week. The King of Pentacles talks about receiving a cash infusion of some kind into your account. Okay, so you're flush, you're good, things are looking nice, things are looking very nice. Now, moving on to your physical health. What is coming in for Taurus in terms of their physical health this week? What is coming in for Taurus in terms of their physical health? The Star, healing. This is a very particular type of healing. This is like rejuvenation. This is like on a cellular level, okay? It's going to make you feel really good. All right, this healing is going to make you feel great. I also see a lot of optimism for the future. The Emperor. If you are a masculine watching, you are in the prime of your life, okay? This is the divine masculine. You've never looked as good as you do now. You've never felt as good as you do now. You are radiating the Emperor's energy. So you look very stable. You look very masculine. You are probably very fit as well. Physically fit, I would say. Now, this card came up reversed, the Knight of Wands reversed. But we do want to watch out for impatience, hot-headedness, anger. We want to watch out for impetuousness, being a bully, pushing ahead, you know, like a bull does. But this energy is frustration. This energy is holding back on passion. So we have Scorpio double Sag here. Of course, you could have this in your chart. We could be dealing with someone like this, but I do feel like you could be butting heads with a younger fire sign here. So watch out for that. But I, you know, the Emperor is a Taurus energy, even though it's Aries. I read it as Aries, Taurus, or Leo. But someone here could be very impatient, and as a result, you know, could be doing something here that is improper to some degree. I don't know what. I just pick up frustration. I do pick up some anger management issues. I pick up a little bit of intolerance as well. You know, hard-headedness. Okay, I think we get the point. So let's move on here to your communications. What is coming in for Taurus this week in terms of their communications? What is coming in this week for Taurus in terms of their communications? The Eight of Cups. So someone is going to be communicating about walking away here or something that they're disappointed about. Usually this is an internal, and something that you've internalized, like a feeling inside, but the Star is here, so that's good. A Scorpio and Aquarius are making an appearance in terms of your communication. There you are, the King of Pentacles. Someone may feel like walking away. They may not tell you this. This is someone that you are, you have a great potential to reconcile with. It could be a Scorpio. This is not to be taken lightly. Someone is not happy with the situation here. Now, the problem is that I don't feel like they are telling you. I don't feel like they are communicating this to you, Taurus. And there's this beautiful Star between you. Now, tell me, why is the Eight of Cups here? Or this is you? Why is the Eight of Cups here, Taurus? The Page of Swords. Could be a Gemini. Someone's been watching you, and, you know, that's a dangerous thing to do because we don't know. Is it on social media? Oh, they may not know everything. Yes, it is on social media. Clarify the King of Pentacles. The Nine of Cups. The Seven of Wands. Well, you're doing fine. You're happy. You're pleased with yourself. And maybe you're going to block this person eventually, or honestly, you're standing up for yourself. You're standing up for your beliefs. You are looking very strong. And I feel like, I also want to say, like, you've positioned yourself in such a manner that if people are watching you on social media and finding out information that way, all they're seeing is the part of you that you put out there. They're not seeing the whole you. So if they're going to be making a decision about you based on what they're seeing from a distance, it's probably not a very accurate, it's not a very accurate, it's not a great way to be making these types of decisions. But then again, I don't know you, I don't know your story, I don't know this person. It's just the impression that I'm getting from that, from those set of cards. What event is taking place for Taurus this week? So basically, this is communication that you're perceiving either over the internet, or this is communication that you are literally, well, somehow it's being transmitted to you. The energy, you could feel this energy, you could sense this energy, you might already know something to be true. Because a star to me is a great card for reconciliation. It's very optimistic. It's also not to be taken lightly, because it means that someone is like the light at the end of the tunnel here. I feel like you were someone's light at the end of their tunnel. I feel like you represent the star to someone. Okay, maybe you are a star. You could be on social media. Yeah, I feel like this is a relationship that exists on social media, to be honest. I said that to begin with. So that is, you know, stalking is not really talking. But then again, some people don't know how to talk. So what event is taking place for you this week? I went off on a tangent there. What event? Eight of Wands. Something's being launched. Things are happening quickly. These are the arrows of passion. Sagittarius. So you could be talking to a Sagittarius this week. The energy is taking off quite fast. The sun, a lot of happiness. You could be spending time outdoors. This is really beautiful energy. The most happiness. And the Seven of Cups, leaving you confused and bewildered. Why is that? Seven of Cups here. Why is this? This is very straightforward energy. There should be no confusion. But again, I guess there is anyway. Six of Pentacles. That's your energy. So you could be exploring your options when it comes to dating. I feel like you are dating someone. You have people relying upon you, Taurus. You know, because I don't think you're these two people that are begging. You know, Taurus is... Tauruses, if they had it, have it their way, they're the ones giving out the cake. They're not the ones begging for it. And this ain't no hostess cake. These are actually like, this is actually like really good cake. So someone is confused. What is the Seven of Cups, please? What does the Seven of Cups represent in the spread? The Five of Pentacles, Taurus, and the Six of Swords. Confused momentarily by this communication that makes you quite happy, but then moving on quickly. Because it looks like you have people depending upon you, depending on you. You're not going to be out in the cold for long. It could just be a period of silence. Your life is to move in a upward trajectory, right? We're moving upwards, onwards, and upwards. Okay, it's a line like this, right? We don't have time to stay at the bottom for very long. We're not bottom feeders. Tauruses are not. Tauruses, the fixed sign of Taurus, which rules the second house, is all about the finer things in life. And by the way, the north node is there. So I guarantee you, look at the Tauruses that you know in your life. You will see their life is going like this right now. They don't have time to be down here, okay? So if you're going to kiss anyone's ass right now, it should be Taurus's ass. And that's the way it should be. So, Taurus, how is your mental health? I'm gassing up all the earth signs today. I don't know, I'm just in the mood. Just in the mood to gas you guys up. I love me some earth signs, though. I do. I love me some earth signs. God. Y'all are so delicious. So delicious. The Four of Cups, Cancer. A bit complacent here, a little bit bored. But also, this card talks about luxury. So it is like having everything you could possibly want, but still not feeling whole. I was feeling this the other day. I should really write down like my mood when I'm feeling this card, because I literally think in terms of tarot cards, which I'm sure my friends and family think is really weird, because I bring it up all the time. I'm like, oh, I'm in such an Eight of Cups mood. They're like, what? I don't know what that card means. Anyway, yeah. Okay, the Seven of Cups and the Three of Wands. Oh, you're a little up in your head. Daydreams and decisions here. A little bit foggy decision making. This is what I call brain fog. It's the goo, right? It's Neptune in Pisces. This is the smoke screen here. So get outside, get some fresh air. It does look like you are in a period of growth here. You have a growth mindset. I'm also hearing growth spurt. Your energy is very calm. You also have a vivid imagination. You're quite imaginative. You're excellent at creative brainstorming. You have a lot of ideas that you hold in your mind all at once. This is like the realm of possibilities. This is like having a bright imagination. You also are grounded here. You do know how to ground yourself. And you don't attach yourself to one situation. Like, she has multiple things coming and going, calm energies. There's a nice flow here. So I would say you're in a very calm, creative, energetic mood. You do kind of have some, I'm not going to lie, some of the things that you're thinking about might be illusory. But you can use that to your advantage, is what I think here. Okay. I'm not seeing anyone here that has like issues. No one here has serious issues. Okay. Everyone is fine. Now, if you do feel like you have serious issues, then that's different. Use your intuition. I'm not a doctor. I just read the cards. Okay. What is coming in for Taurus in terms of their love and relationships? What is coming in for Taurus when it comes? I would say if you're on any medication or you're imbibing any substances, that could contribute to the brain fog. But it could also be a hormonal thing. For example, if you eat a lot of gluten, you could be gluten intolerant. If you chart, when are you feeling this way? After what are you eating, do you feel this way? What time of the month, etc. You might get a better understanding of, you know, what is causing the brain fog. If you do have brain fog, I'm not saying if you don't have brain fog, then disregard what I'm saying. All right. Show me Taurus, love and relationships. And I would love to hear from you guys in the comments. I don't hear from you enough, but if you want to drop a comment, just keep it kind, courteous, and considerate and constructive. Taurus, love and relationships. Eight of Cups again, the Seven of Arrows. Ooh. We're going to want to clarify that. Can I get one more card for Taurus, love and relationships? Scorpio is here. Aquarius is here. Sacrifice. Ooh, Pisces. Okay. Someone is trying to leave a situation here, and I feel like they're being kind of sneaky about it. See, this is like the same person here. Someone could be cheating on their partner. What is the Eight of Cups? Clarify the Eight of Cups for Taurus. Power. Arthur and Guinevere, the Emperor. That's you, Taurus. You're leaving a situation behind. Clarify the Seven of Arrows. I'm seeing another person here. This could be your spouse, your partner, your significant other. You're cheating with a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. I'm seeing two different. This is like usually the wife or girlfriend. Okay, well, if you're trying to leave your, here's another situation. If you're trying to leave, if you're a masculine and you're thinking, there's a lot of distance between you or disappointment between you and your spouse, you and your significant other, then I feel like actually it's your wife or girlfriend that is thinking about leaving you. Maybe because you have not communicated to them about your feelings of not feeling disappointed here. What is sacrifice? Someone is walking away here. Someone is at a crossroads. Yeah, Four of Arrows. Uh-oh. Trouble in paradise. If you're dealing with the Pisces, they're deciding to play dead in this relationship. If you're dealing with an Aquarius, I feel like they're lying to themselves. Or a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. There is a deception here. Underneath the deck, we have the King of Coins. That's you. Someone is pretending that everything is fine when it's not. It's also possible that while I don't feel like the masculine is cheating on the feminine here, there's a feminine cheating on the masculine. And not only that, both people are in the bed together at night at the end of the day, pretending like everything is fine. So what is this, Taurus? Someone ain't something fishy. Something ain't kosher. I'm going to get in trouble for saying kosher. Someone could be Jewish. Someone could be a celebrity. It could be you or your partner. Or both of you. All right. Show me what's going on with the other stuff. We're using the sex fortunes. Show me for Taurus. What's going on with the other stuff this week? We have the Six of Pentacles, that's your card, and we have the Chariot, Cancer. You could be dealing with a Cancerian or another Taurus like yourself, although I feel like this is you getting spanked by someone. So someone likes to be flagellated on the behind. So this is kind of like a form of punishment here. But the man, if you're a masculine watching, there's a masculine that likes the feminine to punish him. Or if you're a feminine Taurus, you may like to punish the masculine here. I would consider this to be punishment, not punishment. Then if we have a chariot, we have the Chariot, which is Cancer's energy. Conversely, if you're dealing with a Cancer, things look to be pretty chill. Also, someone could like do it in their car or something like that, or something with this could be involving a car trip or distance or traveling or something like that. Movement. I believe Taurus and Cancer are the perfect match. You know, my grandmother was a Cancer and my grandfather was a Taurus. They loved each other until the end of time. And they were very romantic about each other, their entire relationship. As far as I know. It was a long, long lasting relationship and a long marriage. And they had three beautiful daughters and two children that did not make it, meaning they were not carried to term, or they were carried to term, but I think one might have been deceased early on. But they are both, they're all buried together anyway. So anyway, long story, my grandmother was a had juvenile diabetes her whole life, pretty much. So by the time my mother was born, then, you know, there was, back in those days, it was a pretty serious thing. So yeah. Anyway, and actually having children was a huge complication, but being that she was Roman Catholic, you know, there was a lot of stigma against, taking precautions in that respect. So, yeah. Moving on, your ally is freedom, independence, and self-determination. So, this could be someone you're attracting. This could also be an aspect of your personality. Someone likes their GD independence. Someone likes their freedom here. Someone wants to be free. I also feel like this is kind of like my rock star card. Some of you are freewheeling it right now. You just don't want anyone telling you what to do. This could be a friend of yours that you really look up to as well. Anyway, it's an ally. Freedom is your friend. Your challenge is ipos, caution. All right. Well, someone doesn't want to be cautious. They want their freedom and they want it now. It's like letting the bulls out of the pen. It's like the running of the bulls here. So watch out if you're not a bull. The other word for this is Iperos, element, water, planet, Mars. So someone could have their Mars in a water sign, Mars in Scorpio, Mars in Cancer, or Mars in Pisces. Message, be careful. Real joy is on offer, but selfishness and overcalculation could ruin it. So once again, it could be you who is being selfish and overcalculating, or someone you're dealing with. Even though real joy is on offer, be careful, because someone could have ulterior motives here, especially if their Mars is in a water placement. Now, it says, Ipos often appears in dreams and visions as an angel with a silvery, radiant face. Her totem creatures are the lioness, the goose, and the hare. Like the hare in mythology, she is an intermediary between the material and spiritual worlds, a creature of the moon. This means that when you are in her favor, she will inspire you with practical ideas that win good fortune and blossoming health. In opposition, she becomes a siren who tantalizingly leads the way to disaster and even madness. Okay. So someone here is a blessing, but also a curse. Or something is a blessing and a curse. It's almost like someone that has two sides to their personality. You love their good side, but their bad side is really bad. Do you get me? You got me. So anyway, Taurus, some food for thought here. No pun intended. I hope you did enjoy your reading. And thanks so much for going last. That was not intentional. It just worked out that way. It won't be like that next time. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for watching. I send you off with many blessings. As always, Taurus, take care of yourselves. I will see you back soon. Bye.